Microphone two, apparently.
What's that?
All good?
Excellent. My presentation is available on this. It's got a Juniper notebook, so if you want to actually play around with some of the SQL statements, you can. I'm running it locally, so you definitely won't interfere with me. So hold it out a bit further.
Or just ignore it.
Okay. Hi everyone. Thanks for waiting around to the end of the day. I'm Daniel Black. I'm the Chief Innovation Officer of Marie Group B. I don't do buyers. If you want to look me up, you can. So what I'm here to talk about is the how and why Marie B exists today. The ultra quick history that I put here is really a project started as when Oracle acquired Sun in 2009. People didn't know what was going to happen, so they flipped off the code base. However, what was conjecture then really doesn't actually matter now because our purpose now is to be here for our users. So we're here to use a fast, robust, scalable, SQL Server product. There's a rich ecosystem of storage engines and plugins and SQL features that have been implemented in MariaDB over the last 13 years since that day. So it's still going strong. As I said, I'm from the MariaDB Foundation. MariaDB as an entity exists as a corporation and a foundation. I'm just here for the foundation, so our mission at the foundation is to ensure the openness of the code base and the community, to drive its adoption, and to be there as continuity to ensure the code remains open source. So this is not subject to corporate safe harbor provisions or anything else, or shareholder demands, or what the board demands. So in MariaDB 10.7, We added like UUG IDs as a data type. Strangely enough, they look and behave like UUG IDs all the way through, from casting to projecting valid values and that kind of thing. So they're stored in compact form, they're stored in like a binary 32, so they're official storage but actually come out as in the SQL layer. There's INAT version 4, that's a data type, so if you want to store an IP version 4 address, you can. You may ask, you know, what happened to IP version 6? Well, actually, that added all the way back to like 10.5, so it's been around for a while. And some examples of some INAT 6 data types are there, and you can put in like IP version 4 mapped addresses into the table that way. So you could have a full data type already for there. For the multinational, there's the UCA Collation Standard 14.0.0. This was a standard that the standard body came out almost 2 years ago now. However, it's a big jump from where we were before. What this has is like an access insensitive and a case insensitive aspect to the collation. And as you can see, there's a huge number of languages that the collation can apply to. I'm not sure if I have this down or not, but yes, there's a lot there. So you create a table, you just use any character set and add a collation onto that. JSON functionality has been improved, so we've got JSON equals, so these two create objects recall, the white space doesn't matter, the order of the object fields that matter. So we've got a quality there, one actually adopts and stores that. To help it along, there's a JSON normalize. So what you might want in a document store is some assertion that your JSON object is unique. And so what this in management terms, the equals implies the normalized versions are the same. So it's just easy enough to expose it out. So if we have a table, we insert a value into it, insert, you know, almost looking the same thing that represents different, we can get it to fit the as you're doing those. Adjust a pretty, nail list to make display nice. I believe that was a user contribution as well. Add a bunch of CSS functions for the just as a good idea of goals for a test case. So I suppose this will all that. Random bytes, just the random functionality that is added by a user. Bytes will add by the head of the JSON histograms aren't actually related to the JSON type. This is related to the performance of the queries. So it's a representation of the distribution of data in an index. And what this provides is the information for the query planner to decide, you know, what's an efficient way to do it. So here we put a bunch of data into some tables. We did analyze the table and made it persistent. And what we ended up over here,
and for the representation is the JSON version of the table. In the size distribution of the table. But
as you can imagine, as you get more data out of the table, this comes quite significant as to am I going to need to search the entire table for a particular value, or is it going to show up quickly? Another feature that was implemented is this natural sort, and that makes the alphabet version and the numeric version actually separate in their sorting order. So if you've got, say, a room like C, A1, A11, A2, B1, that takes actually the order if you were to actually do it in any strict way. But what the natural source order does is when you get C, you get A1, A2, followed by A11. And so the order comes out a lot more naturally as some people receive. Some interesting use cases for this is say you've got IPv addresses, because the numbers are separated, you can now actually just get a bunch of IP addresses in a natural order, whereas they wouldn't really appear that way before. For those that don't like string manipulation in SQL, you may have come across concat statements that involve expression after expression. This is a function that was implemented, uses a lib format library, which is going to be part of the C++ standard. But, you know, enables you to effectively write a dev statement. Historical set of data, which is just accessed by the additional sort of tax issue. You may have stock prices and you can't run through, but every now and then someone might want to go, what does stock market look like at the low, the Great Depression or some kind of point in time. And so with this, you've got the same SQL statement.
Read only of the root user, and that way it's a service for the read only, not in the
fast exclusion. Turn off bronchi check, and want to actually bulk flow the data. Thank you.